You gotta figure out what it's asking for.
That's the hard part.
No, let's do
it. So, all
so number one, no. Is just, number one is just 0.1, right?
What is the frequency of each allele in the population? The recessive allele frequency is 0.1, the dominant allele frequency is 0.9.
Do you want us to say it in the percentage?
No.
P equals 0.9, Q equals 0.1.
So then the next one you have to percentage, right?
Okay, let's do the next one. In Drosophila, the allele for normal wing length is dominant for the allele for vestigial wing. In a population of individuals, 16% show the recessive phenotype.
So 0.16.
What are they talking about there? Are they talking about P, Q, P squared, 2PQ, or Q squared?
Q squared.
They're talking about Q squared. You'll usually find in these problems they give you the Q squared. Because that's what you can observe in a population. You can observe how many are recessive.
So 0.16
is little a. 16% are little a, so Q squared is 0.16. Can you figure out what Q is in your head without using the calculator? What times what is 16?
0.4.
It's 0.4. So Q is 0.4. P is 0.6.
And then P squared.
But it's not asking you that. It's saying, what percentage would you expect to be homozygous dominant and heterozygous? It's asking for that and that.
So 0.36 plus.
0.36, that's what P squared is.
Plus 2 times 0.6.
2 times 0.6 times 0.4 is? 0.48. State championship match. Jonathan, are you getting this? It's not that hard, is it?
I get it all wrong.
How'd you find the
0.36? Okay, did you see how we got P equal 0.6? Okay, did you see how we got Q equal 0.4? The square root of 0.16 is 0.4? Okay. So if Q equals 0.4, then P must be 0.6, right? If 40% of the alleles are recessive in the population, then 60% are dominant, because it has to total 100%.
So what
squared? P plus Q has to equal 1.
So what squared is equal to 0.6?
So 0.6 squared is 0.36.
So P squared would be getting, if you got two dominants in that population,
just take the square root of 0.6.
It's a chance 60% for each dominant. So 0.6 times 0.6, P squared, will give you the number of homozygous dominant. I lost you there? So P squared, just that squared, the 36%. 2PQ will give you the number of heterozygotes, 0.48.
Can we do 7 and 8?
Want to skip all the way down to that?
No.
What do you want to do?
Number
4. Let's do 4, and then we'll do 7 and 8. That work for you? You want to do 4 together? In the United States, about 25% of the population cannot roll their tongues. Can you roll it? Savannah can roll her tongue.
I can't.
You can't roll it?
Can you scrunch it up in that other thing?
I can roll it. That's rolling.
I can't roll it. That's the only way I can do it.
Well, some people can and some people can't.
Who can?
Oh, I thought it meant rolling, like rolling your arms.
What's the other one where
it's a gene. Some people can do it, some people can't.
Wait, what's the thing when you roll your R's? What is that called? Is that rolling your tongue?
All right, listen. 25% can't roll their tongue. That's recessive. So what is that talking about?
It is talking about Q squared.
Q squared is 0.25.
And then.
So what's Q?
0.5.
500.
So Q is
0.5? Oh,
right?
Oh, yeah, well, the number is 0.5.
So then the other one has to be 0.5. So then P squared is 0.25.
So what now?
So it's 25% plus 50% plus 25%.
So 25% will be big A, 50% will be big A, little a, and 25% will be little a, but that's not what the question's asking for.
It's asking you in a population of 2,000.
It's saying in a school of 2,000 kids, how many students would be each of those?
So you would do
25% are big A, and a school has 2,000 kids.
500.
How many kids are big A? 25% of 2,000.
25 over 100 equals X over 2,000, which is 500.
500 kids will be this. That means 500 kids are this.
Which means 1,000.
So 1,000 kids are that. You see how you can apply the percentages to your whole population?
How did you know that 50% was?
Because
2 times P times Q. 2 times 0.5 times 0.5. Because Q is 0.5 and P is 0.5.
Understand this.
And they gave us 25% was recessive. Okay? You see that in the problem? They told you that in the problem? So Q squared equals 0.25.
This is the first thing I've understood all year.
So Q squared equals 0.25. So how do you find what Q is? Yeah, so Q is 0.5, right? Right? So we got Q equal 0.5. So P is equals 0.5. Right? Are you with me? So you see how we got these now?
So you just like wait and find the middle one for whatever's left.
You can do it that way. If this is 25 and this is 25, then that's going to be 50, yeah. Or you can do 2 times P times Q will give you 50. 2 times 0.5 times 0.5 gives you 50. Make sense?
Number 7.
Wait, I have a really quick question on number 5.
Yeah?
It says 360 have no widow's peak, so that would be 3.6, correct?
That would be 0.36, 36%.
What? So
360 out of 1,000 is 0.36.
360 out of 1,000 goes extra.
So that's 36%. 36% are recessive. You have to be able to find percentages.
For what number?
Can we have a quiz on this stuff, please? Can we have, like, a test on just this?
Wait a second. Y'all were telling me the other day that you hated this.
Nuh-uh. I never said that. I don't know what you're talking about.
Once you understand it, it's great.
No, this is the only thing I've understood.
You need to come ask about things, because I know you can understand them.
I understand this.
You just gotta come ask about them. Like
we should have more math.
That we just talked
well,
about.
Math, you can understand it and you can actually.
We should have more math.
You can understand it and still do math.
Exactly.
No, not if
math
you,
is
not
just
if you
easy.
Truly understand
math
it.
Math is simple.
If you truly understand it, you don't do best.
Math is the simplest thing ever.
Okay. Listen up. Number 7. You need a calculator on 7. See, in real life, it doesn't always work out where the square root is easy to figure out. You see? In real life, it's more like number 7. In a population of certain frogs in which the allele for brown skin is dominant to the allele for green skin, a drought leads to selection against green-skinned frogs. When the drought ends, 12% of the frogs have green skin, and that's recessive. Okay? I dropped my paper. So when we're talking about if green skin is recessive and 12% are green skin, what are we talking about? Where in this population, what are we talking about?
Q squared.
Q squared again, they're giving us. Q squared equals 0.12.
And then...
So what's Q?
0.35.
Round Q root. Is the square root of 0.12.
So it's like 0.346.
Q squared equals 0.12, Q equals 0.346. So you got to use a calculator. This is how they're going to have it on the AP exam. They aren't going to give you easy squares.
Uh-huh.
This is 7. So you see how Q equals 0.346?
Mm-hmm.
So if Q equals 0.346, what does P equal?
0.65 something.
0.654? It's a fun number, 654. That's the answer to the question. That's what they're asking you. What will be the frequency of the green skin allele?
Really?
0.346. You don't even have to figure
that's
out.
That's all?
That's the frequency of the green allele. That's an allele. They're asking you for allele frequencies.
So it would be 34.6%?
No, 0.34. Yeah, 34.6%. Or you could say the frequency is 0.346.
Equals P?
It's P, yeah.
Is the green skin the recessive one?
Because they said, what is the frequency of the green skin allele. That's an allele frequency. See, these tell you the frequency of the alleles. These tell you the frequency of the individuals. Each individual gets 2 alleles. So when you get 2 alleles, you have to figure both alleles, and it takes some math to do that. To get two Q's, you got to do that times that is the chance of getting two of those. And it's a lot lower than the chance of just getting one of those. So in the population, these letters up here represent the percentages of the total genes that are either recessive or dominant. Yes?
For number 8.
Wait, can I ask a question about 7 before we switch?
Okay, yes. Yeah.
So we could have gotten the answer to that one without finding the P.
You didn't need to find P. It was just asking for Q. Okay, so tell me about 8.
Okay. It says, like, it gives you the tasters and non-tasters
yes.
the population. Would you add it and then put, like, I added it and I got 12,563. Would you put 8,235 over that equals to X over 100 to get...
Okay, so are you good on 8? Can I go to 8?
Yeah.
I'm going to do 8 for you. I'm pretty much done all the problems for you. That's good. I'm nice like that. Wait, what time is this period?
5 minutes.
So, on 8, you take those two numbers, they gave you the tasters, which are these two together. The phenotype, these are tasters, see? And these are non-tasters. Because non-tasting is recessive. So, if you add the total number of tasters to the total number of non-tasters, what do you get?
12,563.
So there were 12,563 total in the population, but only 4,328 of them were non-tasters.
So
4,328 is what percentage of 12,563?
Okay. So 4,328 over 12,563 equals X over 100.
Equals what percent?
Yeah.
What's that divided by, what's 4,328 divided by 12,563?
34%.
34%? 0.5. 34.45.
So.
Okay, so 0.345. That's our percentage non-tasters. So this is 0.345. Q squared is 0.345. So what's Q? Take the square root of 0.345.
0.586, so 0.59.
Q is 0.59. If Q is 0.59, then what's P?
0.41.
0.41?
0.41.
And now you can figure out everything else. How many of the population will be heterozygous? Hannah, this is your problem. 2 times 0.41 times 0.59.
Forty-eight percent
are heterozygous?
Wait, how did you get that?
2 times 0.41 times 0.59 will give you the heterozygous. Are y'all with me?
Is that the only thing you can do?
No. Because then it says, well, how many of the tasters are heterozygous? Yeah. So if there was 12,563 total, and 48% were heterozygous, you got to do 0.48 times 12,563. 6,033. That's the answer. This is what the questions will be like on the AP exam.
How'd you get 33?
You got 33?
How did you get
6,033? 0.48 times 12 times the total population.
Yeah, that's 6,030.
6,033, is that what you got?
Just 30.
6,030?
Yeah.
Okay, somebody did it wrong in their calculator.
Today or tomorrow?
Oh,